The Voice app by Adobe is a wonderful app for making excellent presentations in only a few minutes. The range of uses for this app is huge. Let's have a look. The first screen is the Explore screen, so you can see other voice projects that people have done, and you can view those. Or if you click on your Projects tab, you can see projects that you've made, and you have the option to create a new story. So first of all, why don't I show you one that I made just before in about 3 minutes is all it took. So I was trying to tell the students about some study skills, and this is the presentation I put together.
So what's the best way to study? Is it best to do one big block of study? Or is it more effective to break the study up into chunks? Research suggests breaking your study up into a number of sessions is the best way. It's called distributed practice, and you'll retain more information if you spread your study sessions out over a number of days. So remember, plan ahead, don't cram. Your results will be better for it.
There we go. That's all it took. So I will keep editing that for now. Now if you want to go and make your own presentation, back on the main screen, either on the Explore screen or on the Project screen, you just click Create a New Story. Give it a title. For example, at the end of a lesson, I get students to tell me three things they learnt in that lesson and make a quick video. So three things. You've got a range of different story structures you can choose from, so it sort of gives it a feel and an outline already. So for example, if we chose teacher lesson and you picked it, it gives you some pre-prepared slides down here. So it tells you first slide overview, second slide concept, example, explanation, etc. And basically you could follow through with those steps and make your little voice animation that way. But the other option is, if we get out of that, I'll go back to this one, make up your own. And basically you can add an icon, a photo, or insert some text. So the first thing I might do is add some text. Click on the text tab and then type in whatever you want. And it automatically sizes it for you and corrects things. Three things I learnt today. Alright, and when you finish with that, you basically hold this button to record the voiceover that goes with it. So if it was the students, they might just have their name at the start and then start speaking. This is Nathan, and these are the three things I learnt today. If you want to listen to what you've done, you can hit the play tab.
This is Nathan, and these are the three things I learnt today.
If you want to re-record the voiceover, you just hold the button again and it will record over that. And when you're ready, you can add in a new slide down the bottom here. Click on the plus tab. It takes you to your second slide. So the first thing, the next thing I might add is an icon. So there's thousands of icons you can search for. So I might do a microphone, because I'm going to say the three things I learned about using voice. So let's put in a microphone icon. It'll drop that in, and once again you record some audio. First thing was I learned how to add audio to a voice project. Okay, and I'll add a couple other slides. When you add a photo, click on that and you get a bunch of options. You can find images on your iPad, take a picture, go to your Adobe linked account, so your Lightroom, go to the Adobe Creative Cloud, put something in from Dropbox, you can link up Facebook, or you can just click here to search for a Creative Commons license photo. Then just scroll through your options until you find the one you want and drop in your image. If you wanted to change the element you added, just tap on it and a delete option turns up. There's also an information button here which tells you who the image is licensed to, what the sort of license rights are on the image, and you can visit the original source page if you wanted to do more with that. If at any stage you wanted to delete one of the pages, you just tap on the little mark there and you click delete page, or there is the option to duplicate that page. At any stage, hit the play button in the bottom left hand corner to see how the presentation looks.
And these are the three things I learned today. First thing was I
learned. And just return out of that. Okay, across the top you get a couple of other options. So now I've got my presentation, I can change the theme. So you've got a bunch of different sort of colors and themes you can apply to it, the way things might move in and out of the screen, etc. So I might go with a playful one. Actually, I don't like that. I'm going to go with a chalkboard. All right, and then finally, there is the backing music for these little voice projects, and you can choose from quite a wide range of different sort of backing tracks, or there is the option there to choose from your iPad. So I might wish to choose something different. Okay, when you're finished, you've got a couple of options. You can hit the sharing tab. Okay, so you can make your video public, or you can make it private so only people with a link can see. You can copy a link, you can upload it to the Adobe Voice site so other people can see it. Or if you just go back to your home screen, you'll get all of your projects sitting there for you. To access those options for copying a link, sharing, etc., you do need to upload the file, and to do that you'll need to sign up with an account. Your video then gets uploaded to the Adobe site. So a link to that presentation has been added to my clipboard, but if we go to my shared tab now, you can see my shared presentations, and you've got options to share via Facebook, Twitter. You can send the link as a message, you can send the link in an email, you can paste the link to your clipboard, and you can also delete the project. So first of all, let's go and have a look at the project. So this is how it ended up. So this is great in that students don't need a account to go and view the presentations. You can just send them the link, make it full screen, click on the play tab.
This is Nathan, and these are the three things I learned today. First thing was I learned how to add audio to a voice project. Next, I learned how to change the...
So it's fantastic. Simple. I really love it. Makes beautiful little animations that you could use in a whole range of situations. Students could tell you about their day, give you feedback on projects, do tours of their neighborhood for history, do tours of their lab for science, do an absolute huge range of things. Fantastic app.